The Dean Kirby 17 Hours Monday, September 25, 2017. It features a recipe for Queen Victoria's perfume and tips on keeping handlebar mustaches in perfect trim. Staff at a charity shop are trying to find out who penned the rare Victoria notebook that was left on their doorstep by a mystery donor. The 152-year-old book, dubbed the Google of 1865, is titled W. Tatton's Receipt Book and features a host of recipes, hints and tips from a long-gone era. Staff at the St. Anne's Hospice charity shop in Stockport, Greater Manchester want to find out more about it and to trace the writer's descendants. We're desperate to find out who he was and to fill in any gaps before the book goes on sale. Nicola Rust, St. Anne's Hospice shop. This little notebook is a delightful insight into what life was like in 1865, said Nicola Rust, the manager at the shop. We already feel like we know a lot about W. Tatton thanks to the pieces he has penned. We're desperate to find out who he was and to fill in any gaps before the book goes on sale. So we'd love anyone who might be able to track down information on the author to get in touch. Tips in the handwritten book include how to make tooth powder, weld cart steel and brew Dutch gin, and the best way to care for mustaches and whiskers. Who was W. Tatton? The book also features a recipe for raisin wine, details on how to make fly poison and instructions on how to mix freckle lotion. It's such a pleasure to be able to read this notebook and to get a glimpse of what life was like in the 1860s. We're really hoping someone can help us solve the mystery and prove its provenance, Ms. Rust added. Census records examined by I suggest there were two men named W. Tatton living in Stockport in 1871. The notebook contains the name W. Tatton. Photo: St. Anne's Hospice. One was a 68-year-old pub landlord named William Tatton who lived in Reddish Lane with his daughter Elizabeth Wollstonecroft and two grandsons, and who died later that same year. The other was a 34-year-old pattern maker called William Tatton who worked at a railway works and lived with his wife and children at Church Terrace in the district of Heaton Norris. Was he an aristocrat? But more tantalizing still is the prospect that the mystery writer may have been part of the aristocratic Tatton family who owned Withenshey Hall in Manchester, or the Egerton family of Tatton in Cheshire. But Carolyn Latham, mansion manager at Tatton Park, which is now part of the National Trust, said she has searched the records and does not believe W. Tatton is connected to either family. She told I there wasn't a W. Tatton in the families at that time. It's a shame, because it sounds like a fascinating document. It would have been nice to connect it to Tatton estate, but Tatton is a fairly common name around here, and we believe it belongs to another family. Secret ingredients of the Queen's perfume: essence of cloves and bergamot of each 3 drachm, 1 drachm neroli, 1/2 ounce essence of milk, eau de rose, spirit of tuberous and the strongest spirits of wine of each 1/2 pint, spirits of jasmine and cassia of each 1 pint. Dissolve the essences and the spirits of wine, then add the other spirits, and when well mixed add the rose water. How to make a drink for hot weather: 2 tablespoons of Scotch oatmeal, put into a large tumbler or small jug and fill up with cold water, stir well and allow to settle until the large particles of meal fall to the bottom. Forms a most refreshing drink in hot weather, and it quenches thirst more than any liquid. The best oil for thickening hair: 3 ounces of olive oil, 1 drachm oil of lavender. Apply morning and evening to those parts where the hair is wanting in consequence of a deficiency of moisture in the skin. Inus.co.uk